What's up, everybody? Back with another video. Today I'm in Branson, Missouri, so I'm back in my home state, and despite the name of my channel, this is the first video I've actually ever done from the Midwest, so I'm excited to be back home visiting family. Excited to be back in southern Missouri. This is right down in the foothills of the Ozarks, right on the Arkansas and Missouri border. And I actually used to live down here several years ago, went to the College of the Ozarks. Spin around here and show you guys, see the hills over here. So we are down in, like I said, the foothills of Missouri. So mom and I came down here for about 4 or 5 days for the Veterans Weekend. So I'm gonna film a series of videos. One video is gonna be just some stuff around the town of Branson itself. I'll probably do one video around the resort to show you what they have. Today there's a Veterans celebration going on the resort itself. So I'm gonna film that. Probably film some different areas of the town, just to kind of show you what it is. So Branson, Missouri is a very famous vacation spot. We are at Big Cedar Lodge. We own a timeshare here. It's actually part of the Bass Pro Shop catalog. It's owned by Johnny Morris, who owns Bass Pro Shop. So he designed all this down here. We'll be over to place another resort, part of the resort called Top of the Rock. Top of the Rock Resort. It has a golf course connected to it that Arnold Palmer helped design. And so, like I said, it'll be a fun weekend. Finally get to, you know, show you guys a little bit about where I'm originally from. So I'm excited. So let's go check out and see what the weekend has to offer. Okay, still on the Big Cedar resort property, and now we are at the Veterans Day ceremony. So ceremony itself starts in about 20 minutes. So we'll kind of walk up here and see what we can see. This area of the state is an extremely patriotic area for anybody looking for some place you can come and celebrate the great country. Wrap up the Veterans Day ceremony. So weird angle here. So funny enough, when I was sitting there watching the ceremony, I dropped my camera, and the stick that I hold on, it snapped off on the end. So I'm literally holding my camera by my hand right now. Kind of sucks because the weather's crappy. It's raining. Last year it was out on the lawn overlooking the lake and everything. Actually had a flyover. Kind of cool. Had a big aviation flyover and a really big presentation outside with the flag in the background. And unfortunately, like I said, it's raining, so I had a smaller indoor ceremony this year, but it was still really great to see. A lot of veterans there from Vietnam War, Korean War, and then some ROTC cadets from JROTC cadets from a local high school. It was kind of cool to see the different generations. Okay, these guys are getting ready to take off. Arkansas National Guard. So, all right, that's it. I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up, and we'll see what next adventure awaits us today. Hey, back. Our next stop in Branson. And we are still in Branson, so my next stop in Branson, something I want to show you guys, out at the dam. So up on top is a lake called Table Rock, and then below the dam, it's called Lake Taneycomo. Funny, a lot of people think that that's like an Indian name, because, you know, this area actually stands, it's short for Taney County, Missouri. So back when I was in college, sorry, I gotta wipe my lens off. Back when I was in college here, we would come out here on the weekends and stuff and mess around. And I've got something I'm going to show you guys. It's pretty cool. So you see I'm walking in the woods back here. And I wanted to get my drone out here, but I didn't bring it to the hotel. So maybe tomorrow I will grab my drone and come out here and fly. So back when I was in college here, we'd come out here and sit and drink beer and stuff. How cool is that? It's our rock we used to come out on. Yeah. So there's the dam. Up on the other side of the dam, that's Table Rock Lake. And then down here is Lake Taneycomo. Really hard to see, but this thing down here is actually a trout hatchery. It's closed right now for about a year and a half. They're renovating it all. And the little outlet stream here, there's one there and one there. They actually let trout out of the hatchery once they raise them. And trout or, you know, people fly fish up and down Lake Taneycomo here. I used to do that. It was one of my favorite pastimes when I lived here. So, yeah, last year, a couple years ago, I took my drone and flew it out across here. And I never did publish a video, so hopefully I want to get my drone out while I'm here. So, just a little something cool I want to show you guys. Cool place I wanted to show you guys down here in Branson is the Cheeky Monkey Saloon. So this is kind of a biker bar. It's out on Fall Creek Road. It's also, Fall Creek Road is also 165 highway. So barbecue place, biker bar, live bands on weekends. And one of the things you've got to try in here, and we came here for, are the, one of the things we came here for, lady, don't want to be on film, sorry. One of the things we came in here for are the brisket nachos. So if you guys find yourself in Branson, definitely be sure to come and check out. Or you come in the door and the first thing they do is yell. I've already been in here, so sorry, but they usually yell, welcome to Cheeky Monkey. And you can see it's a pretty wild little bar. I'll walk over, look at some of the stuff on the wall. You can buy t-shirts, where we have beer koozies, all kinds of memorabilia in here from the place. Cool bars. And one of the cool things about this bar is they give you a free shot when you sit down.
Right back with you. Okay.
Free shot. You gotta love a bar that gives you a free shot. They will let anybody sign the wall, so just take a pen. Feel free to write. And on weekends, they have bands here as well. So we already ordered the meat lover's pizza and the brisket nachos, so check them out in just a moment. The local here that's going to give you a little background on the pub.
Hello, YouTube land. My name is Randy. I've been a regular here for going on 9 years. And this is the number one place to go to in Branson, Missouri. If you want good food, good service, good atmosphere, and good friends, make a point to come here when you're in Branson. Visiting, staying wherever, it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful experience.
Outstanding. Thank you very much.
Thank you all.
And here is the pulled brisket nachos. Not even sure where to start. Wish me luck. They're remnants of the pulled brisket nachos, and they are extremely good for meat pizza. All right, here we go. Brisket nachos, why you come? Okay, so we're downtown Branson off Highway 76. We're at a place called the Grand Villages. And in the Grand Villages, there's a place called the Hard Luck Diner. This is actually a pretty cool place. It's patterned after like a diner in the 50s and 60s, an American diner. So it has like, you know, like the leather seats, and you get the old-fashioned cream sodas. You can get the old-fashioned sundaes, burgers off the grill, any type of like old American type food like this, you know, like diner food. It's patterned after an old diner. However, there's one more thing in here you can get that you can't get at most diners. Let's go check it out. I'll show you what it is. And this is what's not on the menu.
Giving all your love to just one man. You have bad times and you have good times, doing things that you don't understand. But if you love him, you will forgive him. Even though he's hard to understand. Am I right? And if you love him, oh, be proud of him. because after all, he's just a man. Am I right, ladies? So that means it's Christmas time here in Branson, Missouri. We love Christmas so much. We celebrate it.
This is the carrot cake, and this is just a scoop of ice cream. This video is not going exactly how I wanted it to, because yesterday was my mom and mine, our last full day here, and we both woke up in the morning sick as a dog. We think we had food poisoning from the night before, so yesterday was pretty much a wash, so I didn't really get to film anything. And yesterday was nice and sunny. Now it's not, but I did want to show you guys a little bit of the resort here. So I'm down here by the Devil's Pool restaurant. And then that's the Buzzard Bar downstairs. Food is really great in both places. Downstairs, they have live music usually 6 or 7 days a week. It's one of the fun things to do here. These little cabins are some of the original cabins on the property. It's expanded quite a bit. We've been owners down here for 23 years. And I wanted to show you guys this. The Devil's Pool Bridge and the Devil's Pool. It's pretty neat to see. Oh, they've got the water fountain turned off, or the waterfall. That's crappy. Usually this is a waterfall all down through here. In fact, this is my first time ever coming here, and this waterfall hasn't been running. Okay. And I'm going to get another shot from the lower bridge here as well. If you want to see what the Devil's Pool is, you can pause the video and read that if you'd like. And this is the lower bridge here. At night, this is all lit up down through the gully here. It's really, really pretty to see at night. So this whole resort here, Big Cedar, is owned by Bass Pro Shops, and it's actually a really, really beautiful resort. So we are timeshare holders at the Wilderness Club off to the side, but Big Cedar proper is open to the public. So you can go on, you know, Google Big Cedar, go on the website and try to book rooms here just like it was a hotel or whatever. And you have access to everything on the property. Let's see, there's the Angler's Lodge, the Cliffs, Wilderness Club, Big Cedar, they're all they're all part of the same property, so they have shuttles you can take that goes through all the different resorts. When I did this video, Branson's really known for shows. There's a lot of the older country stars that have big theaters and shows down here. There's magic shows, there's shows for everything. But I didn't really want to do a video on that. That's what everybody comes to Branson for. I kind of wanted to do some Branson off the beaten path type video. One thing you should know about Branson, there is no place in the entire United States that's probably more patriotic and does more for veterans in this area. So, if you're really a patriot and you want to see some things, come down here. There's the Standing Vietnam Memorial down here. I'm getting ready to go over to show you Patriots Park by College of the Ozarks next. And there's just a lot of things to do down here. They are extremely patriotic and extremely pro-veteran. So if that's your thing, and it should be, definitely check out Branson if you get a chance. One of the places you have to visit if you visit Branson is College of the Ozarks. It's right behind me here. College of the Ozarks is one of the top 10 liberal arts colleges in the U.S. In fact, I used to go here for about a year, way back, many, many, many years ago. Cool thing about College of the Ozarks is it's free. You can work. You get assigned a job. My first semester, I worked in the cafeteria. The second semester I worked in the power plant, and you work and it pays for your tuition. And if you stay here during the summer and you work during the summer, it pays for your room and board as well. So it's a really good school to go to. It's a Christian university. They now have a military science department to include an ROTC program, which didn't exist when I was here, but it's an extremely popular area. Come here as a tourist. They have plays here. You can go to church here on Sundays, chapel. When you come in the main gate, this here is called the Keter Center. It's a really good restaurant inside. But what I wanted to show you guys is Patriot Park. This is one of the new projects they're working on. They're getting ready to build a POW MIA all the way at the end of this grove up here. But Patriot Park, I'm trying to remember when they built this. Let's see, it says park built by student staff 2019. So this was consecrated and opened on 2019. And ironically, see if I can find it over here. They flew somebody in for the dedication ceremony who just made news yesterday. Now I'm going to have to go find it. So President-elect Trump's new pick for Secretary of Defense, Pete Hegseth, they flew him in here for the dedication ceremony. So he actually has a brick here. I've got a brick here too. I just don't want to show it to you because I don't want to put my real name out there for everybody to see. Okay, I'll find out later. So this is a different tribute to all the different wars we fought in. This is the newest one here, the Global War on Terrorism. I believe there's a Vietnam, there's a Korean War Memorial. I don't think they've done World War II. My mom and I were just talking about it. They do not have a World War I. See, this is the Korean War Memorial. And I believe this is the Vietnam Memorial over here in the corner. Sorry, I'm just looking at some of these names down here. Ah, I just saw my brick. It's over here. I don't remember where Pete Hegseth's brick is. Mom showed it to me last time I was here. Last time we were here. Yeah, so this is a Missouri Veterans, Vietnam Veterans Memorial here. And as you see here, these are all the names of people from Missouri who fought and died in the Vietnam War. So I'm really surprised they haven't got, done a World War II memorial yet. I think I got some rain on the camera there, sorry about that. I want to show you this last little thing here. So this is a tribute to the Gold Star families of Missouri. So like I said, this is one of the many displays they have here in Branson area that show, you know, how patriotic this area of the country is. I definitely, like I said, if you're down in this area, you definitely come check out College of Ozarks. It's one of the cool things to see down here. They've got a full farm out here. They've got a mill where they grind their own mill. They have a bakery. It's like a small city within itself. You know, they produce their own power plant. So it's pretty cool to come check out right down here. All right, we got at least one more place we're going to check out before we have to hit the road and go back home. Okay, right down the road from College of Ozarks is a little hidden treasure I wanted to show you guys. This is down on Acacia Club Road, Mr. Gilberti's. This place is freaking awesome if you guys are down here. It's an Italian place. Their specialty they have for dessert are their seasonal cakes. Strawberry cake's amazing. Right now they have a pumpkin something cake. But this is one of the little places whenever Mom and I come down here, like, we have to stop here and eat at least one time. So we're hitting it up on our way out of town since we missed it yesterday. So I'll show you what the guys look like on the inside. Thing you notice when you walk in is this smell, this waft kind of hits you in the face, and you automatically know everything in this place is good. You can get your little memorabilia for the place, and you also come right up and see a lot of the awards they have. TripAdvisor, best Italian restaurant 3 years in a row, best pizza restaurant 2 years in a row. So like I said, it's definitely some place you want to check out while you're here. Let me get you a little bottle of Chianti to go. A lot of the local Branson stars coming here to eat, as you see on the walls. Excellent. Cute little place. And very, very good food. So definitely Make sure this is one of your stops next time you're in Branson. Got the lasagna with meat sauce and a sausage link with it. Mom got the, I'm going to have to read this. Mom got one of the specials. It is ragu beef and black truffle ravioli, marsala sauce, and sauteed mushrooms and onions. Yum, yum, yum. Set outside, their cakes is what they're really noted for. So we've had the strawberry cake, the orange dreamsicle cake, the lemon cake, and there's another one, right? Strawberry, orange dreamsicle, lemon. And this is the pumpkin spice cake. So if you're here, make sure you get a piece of cake. Probably to go, like us, because by the time we get to through our meal, we can't even think about eating that. You guys have shot down here on the lake since I talked about it previously. So this is Lake Taneycomo down here. You can see how clear the water is. This is the lake where they let the trout in, and you can see some people out here fishing. Ooh, I really miss fishing in this lake. You see, it flows like a river, but it's actually a lake, so it's a little misleading. Good times. Okay, that's going to do it for our time in Branson. This was just kind of my Branson off the beaten path video. Now we've got a 4-hour drive, and after eating all that lasagna, I'm going to be doing it's going to take all I can to stay awake. So, all right, hope you guys enjoyed the video. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you soon.